early paintings of Raffaella Simon seemingly resembled distorted or warped abstract structures. Yet their title said, Teppichgeschäft, Carpet Store, or Staubsauger, Vacuum Cleaner. Today, the titles of her seemingly figurative paintings sound factual and appropriate. But are they? The paintings are called Grundstück, Property, Roter Käfig, Red Cage, or simply Blau, Blue. But as paintings are not made from words but from colors, things might be more complicated. With caustic wit, Raffaella Simon probes our clichéd, caged-in, or fenced-off perception. When Albert Oehlen started out in the late 70s, the premise for his work was that the world was damaged, and so was painting too. But despite everything being damaged and overcome, he did not even attempt to undo this loss. He rather invented an openly fragmented image, a kind of painting which is not just one-dimensional, but manifold, like a mental collage. The pictorial cohesion is precarious, planes and gestures blur into one another, yet, if such diffusion is brought into focus, its painterly contemplation might just be absolutely contemporary. The oeuvre of André Butzer embodies the extremes of history. Painterly, all colors, lines, planes, figuration and abstraction, politics, art and pop culture become one. Fusing together the contradictory extremes of the 20th century, Butzer's paintings become emblems of human existence. Their origins, says the artist, being red, yellow and blue. The abstract primary colors, as well as a fourth primary color he added, the color of flesh. In face of all abstraction, the incarnate embodies a consoling physical presence, a human presence, that is. And it is a welcoming presence, like Titian's Dreaming Venus, Cézanne's Bathos, or even an ice cream parlor like Baskin and Robbins. Jana Schröder's paintings have been derived from a scriptural practice. Initially, letters and initials covered her canvases in lines or columns. Yet over time, her ever-evolving painterly gestures fractured and abraded any literal legibility. Text became texture. She transposes the visualization of a corporal presence into sheer ornamental excess. And while doing so, she candidly makes use of most contemporary image techniques, such as digital layering or superimpositions. As spontaneous as the paintings of David Shutter may appear, he actually paints art history. He paints art social conditions and its blind spots. Therefore, his analytical practice includes the close on-site examination of artworks and research at museums, archives, or storage facilities. Through dense layers of intriguing color, for instance, he reveals the traces of Manet's, Jean Martin's, and Franz Hals' real-life entanglements, their achievements, and even shortcomings. Ulrich Wolff is well versed in the highs and lows of the modernist strategies of artistic self-presentation. He's a painter of mischievous austerity. For example, by daring to counter impersonal and immaculate geometric abstractions with his own signature. In this regard, his paintings have a certain theatrical quality. You can never be sure if they are seriously performing or if they are performing seriousness. Be they now untitled, unbound, or even Senza Piombo.